Hi guys, welcome back to another advice video with Jess Hover. I'm really excited to be hanging out with you. Also excited because today is the first day of the Calling All Skaters DTS here, which means I'm living with, I think, like 9 guys or 8. And they're all skateboarders and they're out on the street right now. So I can take advantage of this time and make this video, which was originally called Things You Might Be Doing That Might Be Working Against You. And so we filmed that video and edited it. And then upon watching it a few times, we actually decided that we didn't like it anymore. That was me and Sean. And so I've been refining these thoughts and now I have a new video for you that is called Things Girls Do To Feel Good That Aren't Actually Good For Them. And so I'll just launch in. Some are obvious, some not so much. And the first one is tanning. And I get it, because I love to be tan too. It feels nice when you're tan, but you look old really fast. And so I don't think you should do it anymore. If you like to tan, I think you should get Jergens Natural Glow. That's what I like. That lotion that you put on, I'm not wearing it right now, but the lotion that you put on and it makes you look gradually tanner and it's really nice and it's moisturizing. So that's good for you. There's also a really cool product that my friend Nova got me once that was called, I think, Saint Tropez or Saint Tropez or something. It was foaming and you spray it on a mitten and you rub the mitten all over you and then you're tan and lovely like instantly and it lasts for a while and looks really natural. So I recommend you do something like that. Second one is passive aggressive posts on social media. So you're on Facebook, you've got something against someone, instead of going straight to the person, you post a status about them. I don't think you should do that anymore. It doesn't actually make you look good, even though you feel good in the moment. It's probably complicating the issue that you have with that person to begin with, because they're probably gonna hear about it, even if they don't see it. And overall, it's just not the best way to handle the thing that you're going through. So don't do that. Social media blasting of anyone of any kind, I think you shouldn't do it. Leave social media for like the fun stuff, the exciting things you're doing, and handle private issues privately. Okay, the next one is smoking. We know, the Surgeon General already told us on the pack of cigarettes that it's bad for us, but I'm talking to you about it because you're still doing it, some of you, and I just don't think you should anymore. Again, it's like the tanning thing. You age faster and you smell bad and it's bad for your teeth. It's bad for your lungs. Pregnant ladies can't hang out with you and I'm pregnant and I love hanging out with you. So I don't think you should smoke anymore. Okay, next one is I'm just gonna do me. That phrase, you've probably heard it before. A lot of friends say that to me when they're like heartbroken or they've gone through something that just leaves them feeling yucky inside. So they're like, you know what? It's fine. I'm stronger for it. I'm just gonna do me. And usually that ends up meaning I'm just gonna live selfishly and hopefully I'll feel better at the end of it. And the thing is, they don't feel better. And here's why, I think. It is more blessed to give than to receive. I didn't come up with that, that's from the Bible. But that is a principle that I've seen lived out over and over and over again. You will be much more satisfied and fulfilled by living a life of love and service for other people than you will by trying to live a life that's solely for you. Okay, the next one is following your exes online, like on Instagram or Facebook or whatever, staying connected with your exes. You know your relationship better than I do. So in some cases, that's not so bad. I have exes that I'm still connected with online and it's not a big deal. But sometimes it's not healthy and I think you'll know. It's like you kind of are aware of what they're doing. You can tell me, like if I asked, hey, what's so-and-so been doing lately? You can tell me like, oh, well, his last photo was this and this. I don't know, because if you're not actually connected with them, social media makes you feel like you're connected with them. And so if you're trying to actually grow separately and like move on, social media can really hinder that process. Also, this is gonna sound crazy for some of you, but I've seen it played out and it's real. Sometimes what you'll end up doing is like kind of scrolling through his stuff, seeing what he's been doing, and then you see like, oh, he liked this girl's photo. Who is she? And then you end up on her page and you don't even know who she is. And then you're scrolling through her stuff and then you're on her Facebook and you're on her blog and you're reading her tweets and you don't even know her. And now you're comparing yourself to some girl that he may or may not care about. And it's super unhealthy and not good for you. So I think you should become a radical unfollower and radically unfollow anyone that is not good for you. Ex-boyfriends, maybe you should follow your boyfriend, ex-boyfriends, girls that aren't your friend, but some ex-boyfriend liked their photo, definitely don't be following them and don't be floating around on their Instagrams. And yeah, I would just say follow people that are life-giving and edifying and you're actually connected with, and unfollow the rest. Okay, that's the end of my advice video. See, that was fun and pretty easy, right? If you like what you see, go ahead and like it. Subscribe to the channel. Next week, Sean and I are gonna be doing a video that's called Be More Fun to Date. It's for girls and it's about dating and it is actually fun. And yeah, I'm gonna try and post a video every week if I can just be quick at editing. And I'd love to be connected with you. So you can follow us on Instagram. I think I'm gonna get a Twitter, and when I do, I'll tell you. I'm on Facebook, I have a blog, and would love for you to hang out there sometimes. And yeah, I would just love to know you. If you have questions or comments, or you want me to talk about something in particular, I want to hear from you. And that's all. I hope you have a great week. I'll talk to you soon. Bye.